Hello and welcome to my garden for the first time in this year. It is gray and it is cool, and I almost didn't make the video, but then I thought, you know, even gray days are beautiful in the garden. I'm so excited to be out here and to see what's growing. Spring always feels like Christmas to me. I am running out of the house and seeing several times a day, what is sprouting? What is growing? And I wanted to share that with you. Starting us off in the shady part of the garden, which of course means hostas. Look at these wonderful spikes. I love the shape and color that's showing up here. I always think the garden is such a great place to get inspired to draw. The birds do too, clearly. And here's something. I'm not sure exactly what it is. I think in this area I generally have a hellebore, and I'm so excited because I bought another one to add to the garden. I'm bringing you on this tour before I add anything new so we know exactly where we started, which inspires me. Maybe I'll add a picture of what this garden was like when we first moved in. Here's my spider wart. Oh, look. Look at how dark it is here at the and dry here it is in the tips. Here's my astilbe. Oh, things change all the time. Do you know what? I was out here yesterday and I don't remember seeing this little guy at all. It's so exciting. This is why I often come outside several times a day at this season, often yelling at Justin, Justin, you have to come out and see this. Here are some more hostas. Man, I love the shapes and colors of them at this stage. I don't remember noticing that before. It's one of the reasons I like getting right down and having a good look. This is my white bleeding heart, and I have to say it is one of my favorite plants I ever got. It was the first plant I ever ordered online, where I got just a little tuber, and I was so skeptical it would actually grow, but now I've had it for years, and I just love the crazy way. Now it looks like celery, doesn't it? But when it grows up, I always think it looks like little aliens coming to life in my garden. I absolutely love it. Here we've got a whole bunch of space, and you know what? I have a tendency as a pretty novice gardener to get in there and plant something and then discover pretty quickly that there's something that's just not started yet. Here's my beautiful hydrangea. It is starting to show some signs of life. I did some cutting back of it. Again, I'm such a novice, and sometimes I just get in there and try things or trust my instincts as opposed to actually learning what you should do. This year I'm trying to do a little more learning. I have tried so many things at this spot in the garden, and finally I think I found something that likes being home here, which is the obedient plant. It's gonna have lovely white flowers. Oh, here's something else I saw for the first time today, look. Oh my goodness, I love how these sedums show up. This is Sedum Junior, and my sedum, you may have heard the story, ended up on the other side of our fence. And Sedum Junior, I reached over like this. I was like, oh look, there he is. And I pulled him over and I replanted him here at home. I'm so excited to see him growing. And then again, we've got a whole stretch of what might be space for something new. And oh, I always forget what this is called. And what it reminds me of the most is that these colors, this combination of this beautiful green and white, it was one of my mom's very favorites. So I always love having that in my garden, and it makes me think of my mom. This is something I planted new last year and I already forgot what it is. No idea. None whatsoever. Maybe phlox, but it looks a little full for phlox. This is one of the most amazing plants that I have. It's a kind of geranium. I'll put up the name. Thank you to somebody who identified it for me last year because I didn't know. One of the things I love about it is if you rub the leaves, I wish we had smell-o-vision. Oh, it smells fantastic. And it gets these pretty pink flowers, and it is so hardy. I put some in this very troublesome little corner by the water spout, and you can see it's doing just fine. Unlike my sage, that sage, right? I don't think that's coming back. I haven't given up yet, but I'm not feeling too hopeful. unlike my chives, which are going crazy. I was trying to have some herbs here right by the stairway so I could pop out and grab them for some cooking. My lovely tree. Unfortunately, he's not doing so well. Look at that. But I always love seeing how the little extra bright green growth. Here I have this little something something. It's got pretty white flowers and I have it in two places in the garden. And yes, I've forgotten its name. I have my little garden guardian. I love him so much. I have had this little friend since I think I was in grade 9. Look, the tree peony. I'm so excited to, oh, look! Oh, I didn't know! Ah, oh, there's a bud! Yay! And I think I see the beginnings of when there and there. See, like Christmas! And here. Oh, this is so exciting, I have to say. When I planted this the very first year, I had one very thin bloom. So finally, I think my tree peony is feeling at home. And so clearly is Sedum Senior. I also brought him back into the garden. And this year I decided to go with some tulips. You might have remembered at the end of last year, I covered the bulbs with some chicken wire, some to hope that some of them would survive the squirrels. And look, wow, it looks like they did. Aren't they spectacular? I have been enjoying them every single day. There's four there, which probably means one bulb got eaten by a squirrel. Oh, sorry, I was so excited. My vinca. Look, my vinca is blooming. I bought this for my mom. I bought two. One is going to stay in the garden and one is going to go be planted at the cemetery. So I'm so excited that that's blooming. It's also called periwinkle. This is one of the irises I have in my garden. I am wildly in love with the foliage, and that is a good thing because it has never once, not once ever, bloomed. Here is some phlox. It's going to be pretty white flowers. And why do I remember some so readily and some not at all? Here's another coming tulip. Now that looks like it's going to be one of the parrot tulips that I bought at the Toronto Botanical Gardens. Here we have another little friend in the garden and he is watching over my mock orange. I have cut this back as well. And I've bought another one of these. These have a lot of memories for me and are one of my very favorite plants. Look at this tulip that never was. What a dramatic shape it cuts in the garden nonetheless. This is also something new. I bought this last year. No idea. And this? No idea. Oh my goodness. I'm going to have to go over my videos from last year to find out what these things are. Here is a beautiful little dogwood bush that I bought at a street sale. It's from one of my neighbors. More beautiful tulips. Some other irises. These are new to my garden. I also got these at that sale last year. I have no idea what they're going to look like. I'm so excited to find out. Tulips. At least some of my very favorite flowers in the whole world. Look at how wild they look too. These are peonies. Look at how wild they look as they grow. Just so full of energy and aliveness and shape. And no wonder people spend a lot of time drawing things they see in the garden, painting things they see in the garden. I am so excited to see these come to life. I've got to show you truly the tiniest tulip I've ever seen. Look at this baby tulip. So this is one tulip. And just to give you some perspective, here is the other one. I don't know what's going on there. I am also beyond thrilled to see these. I had planted these daffodils again as a kind of celebration of my mom, who when I grew up in Montreal, she planted these underneath our trees. And I thought, oh mom, I am going to do the same thing under my beautiful white lilac tree. Do you hear that? Clearly my mom thinks that's a wonderful wonderful idea. But they weren't coming up at all, and I was just distraught until this week they started to show. Oh, this is going to be another wonderful white flower that I don't remember. This is another little one that was across the way. I think I have to finally give up on this rose. I don't think it's going to do anything at all. Oh, look, look, look. See, sometimes you have to look really, really, really closely. See this? That's signs of life from my clematis. I am so excited. I'm also going to have to give up on this rhododendron. It was my mom's and she really loved it and I had hope, but I think it's time to say goodbye. And lastly, more of those irises. I'm really looking forward to sharing with you as these things continue to grow. And I really wanted to show it to you as it is today, here at the very beginning of the season, before I put in anything new, so we can watch how it develops over this summer. Thanks so much for joining me here in my garden. I'm Jamie from Jamie Ridler Studios.